It's going to be a fun night. Parents, families, friends, and scholars, welcome to the class of 2023's high school graduation ceremony. Today we gather to celebrate the incredible accomplishments of our graduating seniors. Normally at this point, I would walk away from the mic and get this show rolling, but I turned 50 this year, so thank you. In addition to gaining a few pounds, I feel like I've earned the right to share just a little bit of advice. Thank you, appreciate that. One, exercise. Not so that you can lose weight. Exercise is the best way to clear your mind and to solve a lot of problems. Get outside and exercise. Two, start investing now. Don't wait. Do you remember those lessons in your algebra classes where they talked about exponential growth? You folded paper a couple of times and all of a sudden it was on the moon? That's what happens to your money when you invest. Thank you. I'm liking this crowd. Three, make connections. Whether it's with your coworkers, your friends, your family, make and keep connections. They are what's going to keep you grounded. I know we all want to be independent, but there's going to be a time that you need somebody, so foster those connections. And lastly, call your parents every now and then. It took me until I had a graduate that moved away to really understand how special I would feel when she called or when she texted or when she sent me a video. It means a lot. And graduates, you won't understand until you are a parent yourself. This one's for parents. When your kids ask you to download some crazy app that they want to use to communicate with you, just do it. All right, seniors, as we commence with this momentous occasion, I kindly request that you take a moment to acknowledge and express gratitude to the parents who have steadfastly supported you throughout your high school journey. I'd now like to welcome our valedictorian Soleil Sanchez and our salutatorian Taylor Auger to lead us in the pledge and our core values.
Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for the core values. We are committed to creating an environment of professionalism and acceptance. We are committed to excellence in all that we do to maximize personal and academic growth. We are committed to academic achievement and discovery. We are empowered to dream without boundaries. We are empowered to achieve beyond test scores and without judgment. We are empowered to lead without fear. We dream, we achieve, we lead. Please remain standing for the national anthem performed by our company performance group under the direction of Karen Fleming.
Early light, what so proudly we You may be seated. We will have one more performance by our company performance group under the direction of Ms. Karen Fleming.
Please welcome to the stage this year's valedictorian, Soleil Sanchez.
Last time we were here, I was practicing sitting and standing with all of you for 2 hours. And now here we are again, but at the end of these 2 hours, we will have graduated high school as the class of 2023. None of us here would have gotten to this point on our own. We are all a collection of the people who have believed in us, challenged us, and even the people who doubted us. We all had someone that had to teach us everything we knew as kids, even though later on in life they would add letters to math for no apparent reason. So today, I hope you find your own way to show the people that helped you get to this shared destination how much you appreciate what they have done for you. Without the people in your life who have supported you, you would not be able to take this next big step in your life. On behalf of the class of 2023, I want to thank all of our teachers because we all had that one teacher that made their class our favorite. Personally, I would like to thank two of my favorite teachers. Mr. Loving, wearing neon sunglasses anytime I would see him after school, and Mr. Hyatt, who wore full suits every day in like 90 degree weather. But I think these two teachers taught me something that all of you have probably learned from someone in your life. Mr. Loving taught me how to do so many different things while trying my absolute best at each one. You don't have to be the best at anything. You just have to try your best at everything. I won't ever be able to look back on my high school years without remembering the complete support and fun times having Mr. Loving as my FBLA advisor. And Mr. Hyatt, I don't know where he is, but, and Mr. Hyatt. I had Mr. Hyatt as my government and econ teacher in my sophomore year. At the end of the econ unit, he taught me the greatest lesson he had ever learned in his life, and I still remember it. And I will pass on to you this wisdom that he gave to me. He said, and I quote, "You will fail." Scary words for any student, just as they turned in their final. He said, "You will fail." And he didn't say, "You'll fail and that's okay." He said, "You'll fail again and again and again. That's life." I know that's a little depressing to think about, but it's true. Looking back, Mr. Hyatt wanted his students to be as well prepared as possible. So I want to thank these two teachers for teaching me that life will always have its ups and downs. We'll have its ups and downs. Each point in our lives will have challenges, and that's just how life is. Exciting, fun, and scary. I'm happy to have had the teachers that shaped my adolescence. But I feel like I can't talk about my adolescence without talking about the sacrifices of our families. Though I can't speak for everyone's family, but I know my family has done everything they could to ensure that my future was as bright as possible. I would like to thank my beloved friends, you know who you are, and although he's not really my friend, Christian Anderson, who was just blindly supportive of me. My family is here today, and I could not be happier for them to watch me graduate. This is for my family and all our families that are here, and as they listen, do not understand what I'm saying. Mi familia cruzó cerros para que yo pudiera tener una vida más fácil que ellos. Mis abuelitos me cuidaron mientras mi mamá y pa estaban trabajando cuando era niña. Mis tíos y tías me quisieron como si fuera su propia hija. Pero más que nada, les quiero dar gracias a mis papás. Mi mamá, que no me pudo ayudar con mi tarea de escuela, pero aquí estoy con todo el apoyo de mi mamá hablando con ustedes hoy. Mis hermanas mayores me ayudaron con todo y me enseñaron a hablar inglés. Mi papá se aseguró que nunca me faltara nada para la escuela. Pagó por mis útiles escolares, mis paseos y mis exámenes. Mis papás y abuelitos están muy orgullosos de mí, pero ellos me dieron algo que ellos nunca tuvieron, la oportunidad para continuar mi educación. A todas las familias aquí, todos estos estudiantes están aquí por sus sacrificios, y tal como ustedes están orgullosos de ellos, ellos los aprecian mucho. For all of you who did not understand, I just think my family is Spanish. Just like I couldn't be here today without the support from so many people, neither would you. The people in our lives prepared us for this moment since the first day of kindergarten. One chapter of our lives is over, but we are all reaching the start of an age. So, to end this speech, I want to conclude with the wise words of Taylor Swift, for those of you graduating. The scary news is you're on your own now, but the cool news is you're on your own now. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you for those wonderful words of wisdom, Soleil. It is my pleasure to introduce our teacher speakers for this year's graduation ceremony. Please welcome to the stage Mr. Loving, Mrs. Saccio Felton, Mrs. Kristen Caraway, and Mr. Alex Arnaldi.
Kind of an abrupt cut. Hello, welcome class of 2023, graduates, families, friends. My name is Sean Loving. If I squat down a little bit, is that better? A little bit of a height difference between me and Soleil, sorry. My name is Sean Loving. I'll be one of the faculty speakers tonight. I'm really honored to be here, selected by you scholars. I've been wrestling with the right words to leave you with. At some point over the past few weeks, I have considered coming up and dazzling you with an interpretive dance, but the sleeves were a little bit in the way. I asked my wife if I could do a shadow puppet show. She also shot that down, begging that I don't embarrass her. So I spent some time reflecting on what to leave you guys with, and what I want to talk about tonight is what I think characterizes the class of 2023 more than anything, and that is belonging. You see, when I joined the staff here 3 years ago, I was going through a very difficult season of my own life personally. I accepted a job to teach you guys government and economics to this class right here. That was a crazy year. We went through a historic election cycle. We went through landmark Supreme Court decisions. We went through an entire boom and bust market cycle. We went through it all together, and I'm very grateful for that opportunity. But when I started here, I didn't think that this was going to be a career move for me, just a job to get me through to my next thing. But you, class of 2023, gave me a new sense of purpose, a new sense of passion, and a new sense of belonging. And for that, I'm very thankful. You see, as you guys move into your next step, be it college, trade school, the workforce, a mission, even the military, no matter where you go, it is going to be easier than ever to feel isolated. There's going to be newness all around you. You're going to be working with people from all different backgrounds at all different stages of life. You'll have more unstructured time than you've ever had before. You're not going to be starting every morning reciting the core values alongside your peers. With all that newness, it can be very easy to feel like you don't belong. So I want to give you guys two tips tonight, two pieces of advice that I've received to help you guys combat that lack of belonging and find meaningful community. First, don't take yourself too seriously to where you're unwilling to be authentic. A mentor of mine once told me that if someone is unwilling to laugh at themselves, the only thing they really take seriously is their ego. I think those of you who have been in my class know that I try to model that on a daily basis. Second, people need to feel like they belong before they feel like they can believe. A sense of belonging has to be built on trust. As you go out from this place, strive to be someone that makes others feel more valuable with every single interaction. Strive to be someone who celebrates the victories of others and walks alongside them in their grief. Strive to be the friend that you would want to have. When you're a person that makes others feel valuable, you are a person that they will trust. And again, a true sense of belonging must be built on trust. As I wrap up, I want to encourage you all with this. You will always have a support system here at the Odyssey Institute for Advanced and International Studies, comma west of the Mississippi, comma north of the equator. Once a Minotaur, always a Minotaur. Horns up, you guys. Horns up. Thank you, guys. Congratulations again, class of 2023. I'd like to welcome up someone who has helped me feel like I belong, someone who I trust a lot, your IB Teacher of the Year, Mrs. Sachio Felton.
Thank you, IB Teacher of the Year 2022, Mr. Loving. Class of 2023, you're about to face some changes. You might be excited, nervous, or maybe afraid. Changes could be intimidating at times. So let me share a story with you. A boy gets a new job. He's very excited, nervous at the same time. On his day one at work, his boss comes up to him, gives him a bucket, and tells him to fill out the watering hole about 1/10 of a mile away using this bucket with water. But the problem is, this bucket has holes in it. So the boy asks the farmer, could I get a better bucket? The farmer smiles and says, this bucket is perfect for its job. So the boy puts in some serious work. He wakes up every morning early, goes back and forth between the watering hole and the water spigot. But about a couple months in, the boy starts to wonder, with this bucket with holes, by the time I get to the watering hole, the bucket is half empty. am I wasting my time? Could I be doing something more useful? So the boy asks the farmer these questions, and the farmer smiles and tells him, just look at the path you have been walking on for the past few months. So when the boy looks up, he notices beautiful flowers blossoming, all kinds of vegetable grown. So sometimes in life, we could work really, really hard, but we may not get what we wanted. And sometimes in life, our plans do change. But one thing for sure is, your hard work and dedication will never go in vain, and it could be blossoming where you least expect it. So class of 2023, don't worry, don't be afraid. Just go out there and put some work in, and your future is bright and colorful beyond your imagination. Congratulations, 2023. We love you.
Hello, everybody. I'm going to start today by quoting the immortal words of Semisonic's Closing Time. Every new beginning comes from some other beginning's end. That is the perfect description of where all of you are standing today, in between the end of your high school years and the beginning of the rest of your life. As you specifically contemplate the end of your series of high school language and lit classes, I am sure there are many of you who are wondering, why did I spend so much time these past 4 years reading the fictional stories of people and places that have long since died away? That's a great question. I would answer you here and now that though time continues to pass and change is inevitable, the human experience at its core stays very much the same. We yearn, we seek, we think, and we feel. And through it all, we learn. These experiences connect us across time and space, and there is much fact to be found in fiction. The authors and characters we encountered these past 4 years have much to teach, and whether you chose honors, college prep, or DP, I think that we can find at least three overlapping lessons that can give us some useful wisdom as we journey forward into the world. Number one, a little context goes a long way. Context is king. All literature is arguably for us, but not necessarily to us. Without considering the context of a story, it is impossible to achieve a true deep understanding of its intention. We live in a world of disconnected sound bites, but the human experience is complex, tied to culture, time, and situation. We cannot fully grasp the story of Catherine and Petruchio, Julius Caesar, Blanche DuBois, or Marjane Satrapi unless we seek to understand the context. Don't be satisfied out there with sound bites. Get the full story. Secondly, first impressions should not be the only basis of your final judgments. People aren't easy to figure out. There are layers behind a persona, and sometimes in order to peel back those layers, time is an essential factor. Elizabeth Bennet learned that there was more to Mr. Darcy than initially met her eyes and ears. Don't let the first 5 minutes prove the full definition of a person. And don't let the words of others make out his or her character for you. Austen teaches through Pride and Prejudice that while it is human nature to make judgments, we need to make them more carefully. All of us make mistakes, but you are all capable of big comebacks. Finally, connections with others strengthen and enrich you. As we look at the IB learner profile attributes, I will assert that all of them are anchored to one, caring. Without it, really nothing has any true purpose or value. Everything you do, pursue, stand up for, proclaim, or sacrifice should be done with great love. DP scholars, we learned this lesson best from Cambili, Miriam, and Layla. Connections make us more courageous when we need to be. They give us the drive and encouragement we require at our challenging points, the grace and forgiveness we desire at our lowest points, the praise and affirmation we crave at our highest points. We were designed to be in relationship. We help each other wake up every morning with the determination to do and be better. As you go on to the next phase of your life journey, please don't forget these characters and their authors. Let them become a part of you. And then, go out there and write your own.
Thank you. Thank you. As you prepare to embark on the next chapter of your lives, I want to encourage you to look ahead with excitement and optimism. You have all worked so hard to get to this point, and I have no doubt that you will go to achieve great things. My hope is for each and every one of you is to pursue your passion with purpose and determination. Whether you're going to choose to continue your education, start a career, or pursue a personal goal, I urge you to do so with integrity and commitment to making a positive impact on the world. Now I freestyle. Earlier in August, I shared a story about my favorite teacher that I've ever had in my entire life. Some of you had great fifth grade teachers, whether it was Mr. Domingo or Mr. Burden. For me, it was my fifth grade teacher, Mr. Hegedus. Tonight he's here. And without him, I would never be able to be up here standing in front of you. When I graduated high school, I knew exactly what I wanted to do. I wanted to be a teacher. I wanted to stand right here and speak to all of you. And yes, a lot of people would tell me, you're not going to make a lot of money. It's true. I do not have a yacht. But for 4 years and a total of 10 years of my life, I've gotten to share my life with some of the greatest people on this planet. And I love every single one of you guys. And you guys have all made my life awesome. I would not trade my job for anything. Maybe a yacht, maybe. Maybe. But as you go out and you go to college or you go to the military, you're on your mission, just know that we will be thinking about you every single day. And we are so happy to see you tonight graduate with all that hard work. Minotaurs, congratulations on tonight. Horns up.
Our senior class speaker for this year's graduation ceremony has been at Odyssey High School all 4 years and is a valued member of our OI DP dance team. Please welcome Giselle Martinez to the stage.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Giselle Martinez, and I have been here at Odyssey since second grade. Before I begin, I would like to say that I am very honored to have been given this opportunity to present this speech. I can't believe we're finally graduating. It has been a long and difficult journey, but we did it. We're here. We made it. Thank you to everyone present here today. Thank you to everyone who is a part of this school. Thank you to our principals, Ms. Sable and Ms. Quigley. Thank you to our teachers and our staff. Thank you to our parents, our friends, and family. You all have shaped us into the people that you see here today, and I can say with total confidence that without you, we would not be where or who we are today. To our Spanish-speaking families, I got you. Familiares, amigos, especialmente a nuestros padres, les quiero dejar saber de parte de nosotros, los que nos estamos graduando, que así como ustedes están orgullosos de nosotros, nosotros estamos agradecidos por su apoyo. Gracias a ustedes, nos pusimos las pilas, le echamos ganas y sí se pudo. Muchas gracias a nuestras familias por estar aquí celebrando uno de los momentos más importantes de nuestras vidas. Gracias. As scholars and friends, we have made many memories together. Many good and some bad, most of which we can look back upon and laugh. Many of us have known each other since elementary school, some since middle school, and some have joined us their freshman year. Despite this, we have all gone through so much these past 4 years. Half of our freshman and sophomore years, we went through virtual learning, having classes through Zooms, and having to come back in person, but wearing masks and not being able to be close to one another. We have had our ups and downs, gone through roller coasters of emotions, and have often clashed over what some may call gossip or drama. Despite any bickering, fighting, and disagreements, we have never hesitated to have each other's backs. I consider myself very lucky to have met you all and be a part of this strong bond that we have created. I could definitely say that this is an emotional time for all of us because on one hand, we are moving towards a new chapter of our lives. On the other hand, we are leaving the school behind where we have spent the most formative years of our lives. Over the years, we have had some of the most amazing teachers who have truly cared about us and taught us with great passion. They have given everything they had in hopes of molding us into great contributors to society. To all teachers, I would like to thank you all on behalf of the class of 2023. You are a symbol of our strength and have always been a support, always been a source of support for us all. You are tough in the form of fathers, loving in the form of mothers, caring to us as if we are friends, and strict disciplinarians. But you always look out for us. Each one of you are great individuals who have helped us shape us after our parents and have made us wise to deal with the world after high school. Thank you again for all of the time, effort, and hard work you have put into us. To my fellow graduates, I have known most of you for a very long time. I know that you are all creative and smart in your own ways and have talents that are incredibly special. As cliche as it may sound, promise me this, you will never doubt yourselves. Today we have accomplished a major milestone in our lives and you should all be very proud of yourselves. This is a major step in the journey of our lives, one that should be recognized for its immense significance. This is an act of personal commitment and one of pride. We have all worked extremely hard to get to this day, and our hard work has not gone unnoticed or to waste. Though graduation is not an end goal in itself, it is instead a part of the larger journey of life. Wherever your future takes you, let it take you somewhere. You don't have to have it all figured out now, but take the steps to achieve your goals, your dreams. Do the things you want to, work towards your dream career, travel the world, do it all because you can do it. Your capabilities are endless, and I hope that you all realize that. To end off this speech, I would like to leave you all with a quote that I learned from one of my favorite classes, one that Miss Caraway put up on her mini chalkboard in class our junior year, and it stuck with me ever since I first read it. I feel that everyone here should hear it. Quote, "You can't go back and change the beginning, but you can start where you are and change the ending." C.S. Lewis. Thank you all again, and great job to the class of 2023. For the last time, go Minotaurs.
Please, once again, welcome our company performance group to the stage under the direction of Miss Karen Fleming.
You have been by my side. Can
Thank you, Mrs. Weens. Graduates, the time has come to close this chapter of your lives and look towards your future. We will mark the end of this chapter with the presentation of your diplomas. Will the first row please rise? Edward Clayton Aceves.
You're getting it too.
Oh, God. I'm just impressed he could lift me. Joshua Samuel Adams. Tatum Michelle Aguilar. Chris Saeed Aguilar Guerrero. Taylor Nicole Alger. Ryder Joseph Allen. Christian Michael Anderson. Gracie Mae Alt. Brooke Ann Austin. Lindsay Nicole Barshef. Jaden Elizabeth Bell. Natalie Bencomo. Luke Adrian Beta. Cadence Yvette Bishop. Stephanie Taylor Blass. Colin William Bodie. Paige Catherine Bogard. Storm Crosby Bogard. Michael Alexander Castillo. Carlos Orlando Cazares. Landon Charles Kozad. Harley Alexis Culp. Elizabeth Arwin Day. Angel DeLeon Perez. Yeah. Travis William Detmer. Bree Nicole Dixon. Colton Gregory Dykus. Tyler Joshua Dolak. Joseph Duval Drawing. Olivia Nicole Elledge. Sarah Elizabeth Emmett. Madeline Grace Emmons. Riley Christopher Fletcher. Amarisa Lizette Frias. Ariana Garcia. Isaiah Ray Gaitan. Kaylin Elizabeth Giarusso. Amelia Rose Gillespie. Gabriella Monique Yasmin Juana Natalia Gonzalez. Armani Gonzalez Sepulveda. Charles Arthur Gregg. Marley L. Gurjigian. Nathan Robert Hamlin. Caden Anthony Hart. Ian Charles Hood. Diego Dominic Jaimes. Esmeralda Jimenez. Gianna King Dedon. Ethan Matthew Kishbaugh. Erica Peyton Quito. Adam Andrew Christoviak. Lycan Grace Cura. Luke Daniel Lamar. Jordan Marisol La Smith. Tony Lira. Alondra Lopez. Omar Lopez. Brandon Robert Ludlow. Jared Quintana Mamaradlo.
Dylan Edward Mapson. Imalka Bandera Medicine. Andrew Christian Martinez. Connor John Martinez. Danae Yvette Martinez. Dylan Joseph Martinez. Giselle Martinez. Noah Jackson McKinley. Jeremy Philip Mecki. Berkeley May Miller. Allison Leah Mills. Javier Adon Milton. Jacob Thomas Molitor. Abby Jane Monje. Aubrey Ann Montgomery. Moises Nava. Angel De Jesus Navarro. Brianna Lynn O'Donnell. Amber Pacheco. Woo! Andrew Terrence Pierce. Katrina Amber Penrod. Lauren Perla Perez. Nicole Alexa Peters. Noah Lucius Perciato. Aiden Ramos. Jasmine Paris Redfield Lagos. Ryan James Richardson. Elizabeth Rivas. Andrew Otonio Rivas Garay. Dakota Rose Roberts. Hannah Marie Rogers. Sadie Ronquillo. Ashley Rowell. Isaac Robert Sains. Madison Michaela Sanchez. Soleil Sanchez. Justin Schock. Christian Nicholas Allen Schweitzer. Aurora L. Serrano. Judah Ray Simpson. Alexander William Sturridgeck. Madeline Paige St. Louis. Douglas Christian Stewart. Chelsea Akasing Taswa. Jordan Ray Lynn Terry. Xander Kyle Thompson. Thaddeus Jeffrey Thurman. Madison Brooke Todd. Hannah Manet Trom. Xavier Abenicio Trujillo. Jacob Matthew Tynan. Thomas Eugene Tynan. Jaden Gage Upton. Guy Marty Valdivia. Audacia McCole Valenzuela.
They've got some things.
Elizabeth Raquel Vasquez. Pace Ryan Waite.
May I use the bathroom?
No.
Tristan James Wicker. Michaela Crystal Wigglesworth. Araya Marie Williams. Danielle Allison Young. Ms. Quigley and I thank you for your attendance at this evening's commencement ceremony. Seniors, now is the time to reminisce on all the experiences that you have had at OI over the years. You've had laughter, tears, successes, and failures. These moments that molded you into the person that you are today. You are ready to go out into the world and make your mark to become our leaders of tomorrow. A few words as you head out into the next chapter of your life. Learn from your mistakes because you never stop making them. have a growth mindset, and learn to listen. Always learn to listen. You always have more to learn. Will the class of 2023 please rise? This is it. It is now time to formalize your graduation by moving your tassel from the right to the left. It is with extreme pleasure that Ms. Quigley and I present to you Odyssey Institute's graduated class of 2023. Parents and family and friends, please rise to applaud the achievements of your scholars. Thank you all for coming tonight. Please remain at your seats while the procession leaves the stage. Thank you again.